So if you're like me, you grew up playing video games, and one of the most famous games was Minecraft. At least back when I used to play it, the strongest armor in the game was diamond armor, more than twice as durable as iron or chainmail armor. But when you think about it, diamond armor would actually be pretty horrible. Let's talk about that. Before we get into the science of it all, and trust me, we will, let's just point out the obvious impracticality of diamond armor. For starters, a full suit of armor would weigh more than 20,000 pounds. That's nearly the weight of the largest African elephant ever measured, or the weight of 7 Toyota Corollas. Now, the price of diamonds can vary anywhere from about $1,000 a carat to more than $50,000 a carat, depending on the 3 C's: cut, color, and clarity. Even on the low end, those 20,000 pounds would equate to more than 45 million carats, or tens of billions of dollars. But more than all that, you wouldn't want diamond armor because it really wouldn't hold up that well. Diamonds are known for being one of the hardest materials on Earth, coming in at a 10 on the Mohs hardness scale. And this is where people start to think that diamond armor would be nearly indestructible. But that's because most people don't understand what hard really means in terms of crystal structure. You can think of diamonds as really just a bunch of carbon atoms held in a very specific arrangement. All diamonds are like this, and different colored diamonds really just have a small amount of other elements trapped inside. To see why diamond armor would suck, let's think of another crystal that has a good hardness rating. Ceramic. Yeah, the thing that makes up bowls and tiles has a Mohs hardness value between 5 and 7, depending on the type. Now, Mohs scale isn't linear, so that 5 to 7 range is only about 10% as hard as diamond. But you know what it's still stronger than? Copper, iron, and a lot of types of steel. And if you've ever dropped your bowl of cereal on the ground, you know why you'd rather charge into battle in a suit made of steel rather than one made from ceramic. Because of ceramic's rigid crystalline structure, similar to diamond, it's prone to shattering. Diamond armor would actually be really brittle. Since all the carbon atoms are lined up very exactly, you create these empty planes going through the crystal. So if a sword hit at just the right angle, it could slice straight through this plane. Just a quick side note, since this is a science channel, these planes of empty space are less than half a nanometer wide. So unless you're wielding the thinnest sword ever made, your sword wouldn't actually physically cut between the atoms. But if you hit the armor with your blade, a crack could easily propagate along this line, shattering the armor as the carbon bonds are ripped apart. By comparison, any of those less hard metals would be better as armor because of something called Young's modulus. Now, without trying to put everyone to sleep, basically Young's modulus describes how much something can bend before it completely breaks. And because metals have a low Young's modulus, it means that metals can stretch as a force is applied to it. So if an axe-wielding Viking hit you with his sword, instead of shattering, the suit would dent as it deforms under the force. And besides not shattering, your armor denting helps to absorb the impact, sort of like how cars are designed to crunch in a crash rather than stay rigid to help reduce the force on the driver. But if that same axe-wielding Viking hit your diamond armor suit, then the armor A wouldn't absorb much of the impact, so you'd really feel the hit, and B, the suit would just shatter into 1,000 pieces that he could collect after finishing you off. So yeah, while Minecraft may be fun, it doesn't do the best at teaching some basic physics to its players. Be sure to share your thoughts on the video down in the comment section below. It really does help us smaller channels and the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to see our other quick bits, check out the full playlist here. And don't forget to subscribe so you never miss an upload. As always, have a great day. And remember, there is always more to learn.